Hey guys, I am here today with Pat Turi, and Pat is the owner of Out There Web Designs, and that is designs with an S. Pat works across numerous different website platforms to help build branded sites that best suit your needs as an individual business. And working with Pat, his main goals are really to showcase your brand and increase your business. So, one of the things that Pat and I have talked about in the past, and I thought it'd be really beneficial to talk about with you guys today, is how imagery affects your meta ads and your Google ads. So I will hand this over to Pat to give you a little bit more of a rundown on Out There Web Designs, and then we'll jump into Google ads.
All right, thanks a lot, Carrington, and thanks for having me.
Of course.
I started up Outdoor Web Designs in 2010, so we've been around for a bit. We started off doing web design, and then we slowly graduated into doing SEO programs, paid ad management, and then we got into custom software development. So we're pretty well-rounded in everything that we can do.
That's awesome. So one of the things like I had mentioned before that we started chatting about was advertising and getting into the paid ads, which is something that I am not super well versed with, but you know a chunk about it. So I'd love to hear what your take is, the difference between Meta ads and Google ads, and kind of just help some of the viewers understand the difference.
Sure. Yeah, Google Ads and Meta Ads are kind of interesting. The main difference is Google has a much larger audience to work with. So when you're doing Google Ads, you're d usually dealing with what are called display ads, which are graphic based. So that's your imagery, logos, all that fun stuff. And think of like going to your favorite news site, your favorite blog, all of those ads that are, downsides across the banner and everything else. Those are all display ads. There's hundreds of thousands, if not millions, of websites that are all connected to what's called the Google Display Network. So when you're posting an ad and you lay out the areas that you want it, the locations, the different websites, and everything else, and you have a choice on all of that when you're doing Google Ads. So those display ads go across all of those other websites out there just to get your branding and your messaging out. So that's the display network. And then you have what are known as search ads. And those are the textual ads that you'll see when you do a Google search. So you'll have the four ads up top, you'll have the four ads down at the bottom. And those are all based on keywords, locations, and a lot of other things. So that's basically on your Google, on the Google side of things. You have everyone who's using Google, all the sites that you're going to. I mean, Google pretty much owns the world. They're everywhere. Okay. So when you're working with Meta ads, those ads are only posted in the news feed on Facebook, and that's it. It's the only place those ads are going. So you have a much smaller audience in comparison. Okay. So you can get really, and you can work with a lot of different audiences, interest groups, and all that other fun stuff within the two. So that's the main difference between them is the size of the audience and the type of audience too. The people who are using Google, there's a lot of crossover, of course, but they are a bit different than the ones that are on Facebook.
That definitely makes sense. So when you're creating these ads, how do the visuals come into play?
Okay, this gets into an interesting point, which we've discussed. On Google, when you're doing when you install your imagery and upload your graphics and everything else. All that has to be extremely relevant to the business and to the ad content itself. So you can get into like roofing or any service-based industry, but we'll take roofing just as an example. So you got to have pictures of roofs. You got to have, people working on roofs, houses showing roofs, that type of thing. Anything to do with roofs, shingles, tiles, slate tiles, whatever, metal roofs. Okay. All that has to be very prominent on and very relevant on Google. When you get into Meta ads, they don't care. Okay. And what I mean by that is, you have a roofing ad that you're doing or roof repair. You can literally have a picture of an eagle soaring across a lake. Doesn't matter. The imagery on Meta is only there to grab your attention. So anything that grabs attention. And then you can have all your content. And those two can be completely and utterly disrelated. So that's the main difference between those two.
Do you see that one is often more beneficial than the other?
It really depends on where your audience lives. Usually, when we're starting off an ad campaign for a client, we start on Meta to see if their audience is there. And it's kind of one of those things, is your audience there? Well, until you run the ads, you don't know. It's kind of one of those. So we usually start off in Meta. We'll run an ad campaign for a couple, 3 months. And usually within about a month to 2 months, we're going to know whether your audience lives there or not. But it does take a bit of time. You have the ads to create, you have to get them to perform well. You have some experimentation, do A/B testing and that type of thing. But that's usually where we start. We get ads performing while there, then we can add on a Google campaign and then go to a much broader market. Or we're running those Meta ads for a bit. We run them for 2 or 3 months. Be like, yeah, your audience is not here. We need to move to Google now and do another campaign. And then, get into a more targeted market. We can pull the metrics and analytics from Meta, and then we can design those ads accordingly and adjust.
That's awesome. So if you had somebody coming to you saying they want to get started with ads, is there any tips and tricks you would give them to start thinking about to get started?
Usually, we'll start asking clients, who are your, who is your target audience? Who's your target market? Who do you want to go after? We'll do a little bit of research based on the experience that we've had in running ads, and we can get a pretty good idea. It's like, okay, let's start a Meta. The other thing too is when you're doing Meta ads as compared to Google ads, the budgets are dramatically different too. You have much smaller budgets on Meta, so you can usually get ads running and performing pretty well there. I can say fairly inexpensively. I mean, you're still going to spend a bit of money, but not nearly as much as you do on Google. We start with that, run ads there, and then just see how well we can get them to perform.
Awesome. So, if anyone has any questions or wants to learn more from you, how can they get in touch with you?
Well, and go to our website, www.otwebdesigns.com, or they can reach out to me directly at pat@otwebdesigns.com.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Pat. This was a pleasure, and we'll chat again soon.
All right. Thanks a lot, Carrington.